Macintosh has four-voice sound and speech built in. And it talks to you on an extremely high definition, super crisp, bitmap 9-inch black and white screen. It's really incredible, as many of you might have had a chance to see at the hands-on. We have one last hands-on at 9 o'clock tonight. This screen has over twice the dots of the IBM PC or Apple II on its screen, very high definition. And all of this power fits into a box one-third the size and weight of the IBM PC. It's a truly transportable product. And in addition to that, there's a whole family of stuff that goes along with it: image writer, printers, external disk drives, modems, carrying cases, and a sort of security kit so your Macintosh doesn't go anywhere without you. Now, you've seen some pictures of Macintosh in these slides, but what I'd like to do now is show you the Macintosh in person. And all of the images that you will be seeing will be generated by what's in that bag right there. Now, we've been doing an awful lot of talking about Macintosh lately as well. But tonight, really for the second time ever, we'd like to let Macintosh speak for itself.
Hello, I'm Macintosh. It sure is great to get out of that bag. Unaccustomed as I am to public speaking, I'd like to share with you a maxim I thought of the first time I met an IBM mainframe. Never trust a computer you can't lift. Obviously I can talk, but right now I'd like to sit back and listen. So it is with considerable pride that I introduce a man who's been like a father to me, Steve Jobs.